Santiago.
Mr. President, as principal author and co-sponsor of the RH bill, I vote yes. The Catholic Church has steadfastly opposed the RH bill for 13 years. But I humbly submit this afternoon, there is no idea, there is no force more powerful than an idea whose time has come. And today is the time for RH. In antiquity, the Catholic Church committed certain grave mistakes. Any student of Catholic history will acknowledge that the Church made mistakes because it is not a perfect institution, it is only human. In antiquity, Copernicus opposed Catholic teaching, which demanded that all Catholics must believe that the sun rotated around the earth. Copernicus, on the contrary, taught that it was the earth which revolved around the sun. For this, what was considered a crime at that time, for this great crime at that time, he was condemned by the Catholic Church and tortured. Years later, another man, also a Catholic, repeated the heliocentric philosophy that it is the earth which revolves around the sun and not otherwise. Again, the Catholic Church condemned this man. But in 1992, the Catholic Church corrected itself and said, after all, Galileo is correct. It is the earth which revolves around the sun. So the Catholic Church has made many mistakes because it is a human institution. But there is no force on earth as powerful as an idea whose time has come. That's why Vatican II came to the lives of all Catholics all over the world. The Pope of the Catholic Church, whoever he might have been, has never issued an ex cathedra pronouncement about reproductive health. In the exercise of his supreme pontifical authority, when the Pope speaks ex cathedra, all Catholics are bound as dogma to follow that statement. The Pope has never done that. In fact, the present Pope, Pope Benedict, who is one of the most conservative popes the Church has seen, when he was just a mere Father Joseph Ratzinger and a professor of theology, in one of his lectures said, over and above the Pope is the conscience of the individual. That was the Pope speaking when he was a young person. And that is why I've always emphasized that after Vatican II, the accent of the Catholic Church has been primacy of conscience. The Catholic Church does not consist of only the Pope, only the cardinals, only the bishops, or only the clerics. No, that has been corrected by Vatican II. The Catholic Church consists of all the people of God, meaning to say all Catholics. The clerics are no longer considered sacred in their persons. Their emanations are no longer considered binding, ipso facto. Plus, it is a fact in the Philippines, incontrovertible from the point of view of the human senses, since our law of evidence is based on what the human can sense, his sense of touch, sight, feeling, and so on. It is an incontrovertible fact. Every day, the surveys have consistently showed a certain number of women die because of birth complications, simply because they were too ignorant to control their own bodies. They were terrified that they would go to hell if they controlled the number of their children. Today, modern medicine teaches a woman must give birth no earlier than 2 years between births. They don't know that, or their husbands will not cooperate. They don't know where to buy a condom, and even if they did, they don't have the money to buy it. I can buy condoms by ton if I want to. But a single woman, a single mother in Tondo cannot do that. So the ineradicable, the irrefragable, the clear fact is that today's survey show 11 to 15, maybe 13, to it was to be 11 before, from 11 every day. It is now, the number is now 13 to 15 women die every single day. When this day closes at 12 o'clock midnight, at least 13 Filipina women would have died because she was too ignorant to know about reproductive health. all that this bill furnishes is the proper information for women who need that information. That is the fact that we have to deal with. We cannot pray to a Father in heaven and ignore people living right beside us. If there's anything that Jesus Christ taught, it was this. Love God with all your heart and all your mind and all your soul. Do not attempt to speak for God if you don't have direct contact. That, in effect, would be claiming that you know what is the mind of God. As for me as a Catholic, I refuse, pursuant to Vatican II, I refuse to obey what someone says I should be thinking in my head. God gave me a conscience, gave me a brain. He expects that I should use that brain for the good of my fellow men. That was the first teaching. Love God with all your heart and all your mind and all your soul, and do not presume to speak for him. The second law that he laid down was this. Love your neighbor as yourself. Do we love ourselves so much that we'll prefer that 15 Filipina women, at the very lowest, 13 Filipina women, will die every day, will occupy a coffin tonight, simply because we were neglectful in helping our neighbor? That is the question. So with all of these submissions, I will reiterate that I will vote yes on third and final reading on this vote. Thank you.
Milon.
I vote yes and will submit the written explanation afterwards.
Thank you.
Ejercitor Estrada.
With the permission of the body, I would like to explain my vote.